everyone to Tellace Vinery Resort project launch event here in Sydney, one of the most prestigious hotels based in Sydney. While the memory is still very fresh, not long ago, we had a major celebration in this particular venue. That was about celebrating this prestigious hotel named after Zombon, which is, while the memory is still very fresh, we're now having another massive celebration towards this state of art project, which is jointly developed by Zombon Real Estate Group and the Chinese renowned wine importer Joint Tech Fine Wine Company Limited. As the event was approaching, we have welcomed many congratulatory remarks as well as massive interest. But we keep this gathering to the minimal. We keep this gathering as to our only closest associates and our family members, and as well the most distinguished guests. So with the next moment, please allow me to acknowledge and to thank those very important guests in the room. First, I would like to invite your warmest applause to thank Minister for Tourism and Major Events, Assistant Minister for Skills, the Honourable Adam Marshall MP. And also our shareholders representative, which is very significant, is the chairman of Zombon Real Estate Group, Chairman Ping Wei. And also our chairman of Joint Tech Fine Wines Company Limited, Mr. Zhi Gang Gang. And we also very much welcome Mr. Gao Xingqi, Li Bing, Xu Jun, Xu Yangdong, and Edward Wei, and many other important guests. And of course, the list actually going for some time, our former dignitary of Zhuhai local government, Mr. Fu Xiangliu. Our well-known artist, the Shuai Yan Mei. Welcome. Thank you. And for the following guest, I will ask you to leave your applause by the end of the list. We also welcome the local guest, Mr. Yuan Sanito, Jian Dongxi, Tie Chen Sun, George Chang, Jian Zhang, Qing Gang, Jian Ping Liu, Yan Minggu, Kathy Guo, and Adam Huang. Thanks to everybody, and of course, this list must go on non-stop. We have all the 50 or also important guests in the room. So I do invite your warmest applause to welcome every single shareholders and associates. Zombon Real Estate Group ranked China National First-Tier Property Development Enterprise, ranking top 50 at Shanghai Province and top 100 nationwide. So Zombon Real Estate have demonstrated in Australia a hit in the investment market every single time, such as buying this particular prestigious hotel here. And of course, continued contribution to Australian economy. So with the next speakers I will invite on stage is very significant. He has been awarded as the top 10 Chinese real estate figures and the top 10 outstanding group in Pudongyu district and the Shanghai top 10 men in real estate. And I saw him many, many times in the world-class first-tier industries magazines as well. So now I would like to invite your hands together to welcome Chairman Wei Ping.
Your Honorable Minister, Mr. Adam Marshall, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening.
特别高兴啊，今天我们在这里啊，在我们自己的酒店做这样的一个 party啊，我。 我今天呢，想让这个气氛能够轻松宽松一点，所以我今天的说话可能会有点乱，因为我没有做任何的准备。我希望有个宽松的气氛。
So we're so delighted to meet you all in our own hotel and want to make it a party for every one of you, so everyone could be very relaxed when listening to my speech. So I may go a bit illogical sometimes because I don't want the whole environment to be too formal.
首先我要感谢啊，今天来参加我们这个活动的朋友们，正因为有你们的参与，有你们的关心和支持，才有我们今天的这样的一个气氛，和我们更多的一起来和澳洲投资的朋友们的这样的一种发展的机会和空间。
So first of all, we want to thank you all our friends, great thanks for your excellent participation, your great care, and also your great support for us. Without your participation and support, we would not be able to achieve so much. And once again, we also want to thank all our investors coming into Australia, which opens up new opportunities for every one of us.
这个今天在座的啊，不仅啊有我们中国，包括上海一些在澳大利亚投资非常成功的企业家，包括啊像就我们酒店对面啊，就大家看到在建的那个项目1788的啊，我们投资人啊，我们施董啊，也包括啊我们之前联合地产一起过来投资的啊，包括在市中心大家看到了啊卡斯利啊项目的我们的一些合作伙伴高总啊，包括我们联合的啊 CEO 徐总啊。包括我们联合的啊，这个股东啊，这个我们孙总今天都出席了我们的活动。
So we're very delighted to see tonight we do have lots of successful entrepreneurs coming from different places. For example, Shanghai, China. We have Mr. Shi here, who is the developer of the project, which is located on number 1788.Which is just opposite the Intercontinental Hotel in Darling in Double Bay. And also, we do have some other important guests here. For example, we have major shareholders as well as CEO of United Real Estate Developer, who's currently having a real estate project in the CBD area of Sydney. And also, we have Mr. Gao, CEO Xi, and also Mr. Shen, who are also here, present here this evening.
Hello.更要感谢啊，今天这个活动这个项目我们的合作方，我们这个中国啊这个红酒贸易的第一集团啊俊德集团的主席啊杨主席，包括啊这个我们这个徐总啊这个李总一行，我们成为我们这个项目的投资的伙伴，大家都希望能够在悉尼在新州在澳洲有更好的发展。
And once again, we want to express our sincere thanks to our partner who cooperate with us for the Tellace Vineyard Resort project. I want to particularly thank the chairman as well as directors of the number one fine wine importer in China, the Joint Tech Fine Wine Importer, Chairman Yang, Director Xu, and Director Li.We hope we're able to build more projects as well as more cooperation, not only in Sydney, not only in the states of New South Wales, but also all around Australia.
还有我在国内的合作伙伴，中国做大型户外演艺秀的第一人，我们尊敬的梅赛元老师今天也来到了现场，而且他来的目的除了今天参加活动之外，他更是来考察能够把这种中国大型的演艺秀放到悉尼来，放到澳洲来。
So once again, we want to express our thanks to my business partner from China, Mei Sai Yuan, who is currently the number one person in the outdoor entertainment show business in China. And during his visit in Sydney this time, he's going to do some inspections as well as some traveling to see how he could transfer his business in China into the wider market.In Australia.
当然第二个呢，我想说说我们这个项目啊，这个猎人谷这个酒庄，我是这个先知道猎人谷这三个字，才品味和认识了澳大利亚的红酒啊。我以前对澳大利亚红酒没有太多概念，但是我去了猎人谷，因为猎人谷这个名字好像以前我记得我们在读书的时候啊，在教科书里面就看到过啊。所以呢，一下子被澳大利亚，被这个新世界的澳大利亚的红酒给吸引住了，特别是 中国的饮酒的文化，这个我跟我们杨老板有不同的观点。杨老板喜欢旧世界的，我说我喜欢新世界的。为什么？因为我要干杯，我没有太多的时间等这个酒醒过来，澳洲酒不用醒。
So now let's talk about the Tellace Vineyard Resort. Indeed, all the ideas come from Hunter Valley. But before that, I only knew the word Hunter Valley from textbooks. And before I went to Hunter Valley, I did not have lots of understandings about red wines and white wines from Australia. And then after I went to Hunter Valley, I had a better understanding of both red and white wines from Australia, which are of very high quality.And also my personal understanding in terms of the consumption culture in China as well as the taste of wines is very different from that of Mr. Yang. And Mr. Yang prefers wines from the old world, I prefer wines from the new world. Because I tried to put them up and I don't really want to spend any time waiting for the wine to be relaxed. Because usually wines from Australia do not require the time for relaxation.
2011年，我买下了这个酒庄，这是我在澳大利亚的第一笔投资。我实际上是2006年就申请澳洲的移民，但是我那时候觉得中国太多的生意了我忙不过来，所以我没有投资。但2011年开始，我第一个买下了这个酒庄，然后之后我们这几年里面持续。加大在澳洲的投资，但是今天呢，我把这个项目按当初我买入的价格，让我这些朋友们一起来参与投资和风险。我们希望在越人谷打造一个休闲旅游的度假项目，让我们大家更多的人来体验和参与和享受。
So though I applied for my permanent residency in Australia back in the year 2006, I started doing business in Australia back in the year 2010 or 2011. Back in that time, I purchased the winery in Hunter Valley, which was my first investment project in Australia. And since then, I have been doing more investments in Australia in different places.And today we are fortunate to tell all of you that the price I offered to you about this resort project is the same price as I purchased the winery back in those years. And we are going to create a recreation as well as a resort place in Hunter Valley, so an increasing number of people are able to experience the charm of the countryside area in Australia.
有关这个项目的详细的规划，待会我们的设计师会跟大家介绍。但是我想跟大家传递的信息是什么呢？我们这个度假村是乡村的，也是时代时尚的、现代的，就如同我们今天的这个晚宴一样。我希望把更多的轻松生活的体验、生活方式的建立。通过这样的一个项目，我们能够互动起来。
So later, the architect of the resort will give you more information about this project. And the most important message that I'm going to deliver to you is that we hope the resort can be not only fashionable, modern, but more importantly, very close to nature. It's pretty natural. It's just like the dinner we have tonight.We're in a very relaxing environment. We are very close to life. We don't try to be very flamboyant. We try to be very natural.
当然，最后呢，我想要感谢我们来今天参加活动、来捧场的朋友们，包括我的一些好朋友、老领导、老朋友。我们珠海市刘主席也是我们这个项目的总顾问我们上海市侨办的刘主任也是我们。上海的老朋友我们上海原来政府的老同事我们顾主任，还包括这个澳洲的很多很多的朋友像今天兰格律师的地产负责人Bob也来参加我们的活动江曼我们银行界的我们的这个老朋友工行长我们工行持续的对我们联合一直给予很多支持的 这个工行的领导啊，包括啊我们的这个项目的主创设计师啊 team 啊，大家都为我们整个项目的付出啊做了很多啊，我们啊这个 Ken 啊，这个 TWC 的啊，我们的这个啊中国这个合伙人啊，中国区的负责人啊，等等等等啊，今天来了太多的啊我们的好朋友，刚进来的啊这个 Michael 啊，这个 JLL 的 Michael 啊，也是这个我们中国业务的负责人，都帮助我们中国的企业家进入澳大利亚啊，提供了极大的方便，也提供了最好的服务啊，也提供了最温暖的对我们这些投资人的关心啊，在此表示感谢。
And lastly, I want to thank all our distinguished guests who are present here tonight.And especially I want to express my sincere thanks to all leaders and also my old and new friends, including Chairman Liu and also Director Liu from the Department of Overseas Chinese Affairs in Shanghai, and also Chairman Dong from the Zhuhai government, and also Jiang Man from the banking sector, and leaders from ICBC, and also Director Gu. And also want to particularly thank all our friends from Australia,For example, Bob from United Real Estate Developer, who also gave us great support. And also the other distinguished guests, including partner from PwC, and also Michael from JLL. Thank you all for giving us so much support. And you not only support me, but also you have helped lots of Chinese entrepreneurs coming into Australia to do further business here. Great thanks once again for your warm support, and also,your warm hearted generosity and your care.
好，让我们一起举杯，为我们今天的晚宴，为我们今天活动的成功，干杯 ！Cheers.
Now may I propose a toast to our dinner tonight, and also may I propose a toast to the future success of everyone. Thank you very much.
Yeah. 好，干杯。
谢谢啊。
Thank you, Chairman Wei, for your initiatives and bring our investors into mutual prosperity. As what the Chairman has mentioned, the Tellace Vinery Resort is determined to become a high-end tourist destination and a beautiful landmark in the Hunter's region.And for foreign tourists to explore the actual down-to-earth Australian country culture and as well the wine culture. And today we have our Minister for Tourism and Major Events, the Honourable Adam Marshall MP. And I know that he's been working extremely hard to bring the focus to our regional area. During his time serving as Mayor and the Governor of Shai,His city was one of the only council in New England Northwest to be given a sound in the financial rating by New South Wales Treasury as positive in the New England Northwest area. Thank you for your attention. Thank you. And his contribution and his dedication never stops. And he works extremely hard for the state and regional development. Thank you.And I would like to welcome you to minimize your noise and invite your applause to welcome our honor of guest, the Honorable Adam Marshall, for your remark.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be with you this evening. First of all, we'd like to acknowledge Chairman Wei and all of the other special guests and business partners and those that have already been introduced this evening. On behalf of the New South Wales Government, it's a wonderful pleasure to be with you this evening and to give our blessing and our best wishes for this very, very exciting project for our state.
女士们、先生们，大家晚上好。今天晚上非常荣幸能够莅临本次活动。首先，在我开始演讲之前，我要再一次感谢魏主席及今天远道而来的各位贵宾们， 首先，我代表新南威尔士州政府再次感谢，并且非常荣幸能够莅临今天晚上的活动，并且祝愿我们特莱士酒店度假村项目可以取得未来的成功。
The relationship between our state of New South Wales and China and our country, Australia and China, is very, very strong. And projects like this only serve to deepen and strengthen that relationship.As the state's tourism minister, I'm incredibly excited about a project like this one because this is about helping us attract more Chinese tourists in particular to our state, but also to different parts of the state beyond Sydney.
新南威尔士州与中国，包括澳大利亚与中国的关系早已非常的深远，而像特莱士酒店度假村这样的一些项目，可以进一步深化中澳两国及中国与新南威尔士州之间的关系。而我作为旅游部部长，也非常欣喜，可以希望在未来看到越来越多如特莱士酒庄度假村这样的项目，如雨后春笋一般可以涌现出来。通过这一些项目，我们可以更好地帮助并且吸引更多的来自中国的游客来新南威尔士州体验新南威尔士州的风光，并且更多的体验的是并不仅仅只是城市地区的风光，而是新南威尔士州在其他地区的迷你风光。
Tourism is very big business in the state of New South Wales. Last year, the tourism industry brought in over $30 billion worth of revenue to our economy, and it directly employs nearly 300,000 people. Over half of those people live outside of Sydney in regional New South Wales, in parts of it, our state where this project is going to be.
旅游产业对于新南威尔士州的经济发展来说起到了非常重要的作用，也占了非常大的比重。在去年，旅游产业为新南威尔士州的经济带来了达到300亿澳元的总收入，并且目前新南威尔士州有大约30万人是从事与旅游相关的产业工作，而其中有超过一半左右的从事旅游相关工作的人员都生活在悉尼市以外的地方，即生活在新南威尔士州的其他偏远地区。而通过特莱士酒庄度假村等项目，能够进一步夯实基础，为更多的人带来就业机会和更好的生活展望。
Visitor numbers to New South Wales have grown by almost 10% in the last 12 months, and a lot of that is due to a large increase in the number of Chinese tourists visiting New South Wales. There are in the last 12 months.More than 700,000 Chinese tourists visited New South Wales, we represent the vast bulk of the China, international China tourist market in Australia.
新南威尔士州目前的游客人数在过去12个月以10%的速度不断的向前增长，而这主要是得益于我们有越来越多的中国游客选择到新南威尔士州来进行旅游。在过去的12个月，我们通过我们的统计，我们有大约70万左右的中国游客来到了新南威尔士州，并且这些来到新南威尔士州旅游的数量人数占了所有进入澳大利亚旅游的国际游客的大部分。
There are two very interesting elements, I feel, as the state's tourism minister to the Chinese tourism market in this state that actually are quite relevant to this exciting development which is about to occur in the Hunter Valley. First of all, the Chinese tourist in New South Wales is our highest yielding. They spend the most per person of any international tourist in our state, which we absolutely love. Out of interest, the cheapest,or the people that spend the least when they come to New South Wales are New Zealanders and people from England, which will come as no surprise to those that have English relatives like I do. They are the cheapest people anywhere on the planet.
那实际上呢，当我们看到特莱士酒庄度假村这样的项目的时候，并且我作为旅游部的部长，对于中国的游客呢，我也看到两个非常有意思的特点。那第一个呢，就是来他们每个人平均的花费与其他来自不同国家的游客相比是最高的，而通常呢，来我们新南威尔士州和甚至来自澳大利亚旅游的
游客，可是却花费最少的，通常是来自新西兰跟来自英国的游客。那就像很多的人，因为我自己也是具有英国血统的，可是像我们这样的人来到其他地方旅游，却不愿意花太多的钱来购物。
The other very interesting part of the Chinese tourism market in the state is that in the last 12 months, while we had record visitation of tourists from China, only 6% of those over 700,000 tourists actually ventured outside of Sydney. Only 6%. 94% of those tourists never left Sydney. And that's why a project like this is so exciting from my perspective.Because it gives us another wonderful tourism asset to try and draw the ever-growing and ever-increasingly spend Chinese tourist market out of Sydney into what I think is some of the most beautiful parts of our state, and that is regional New South Wales and the Hunter Valley.
同样的，在过去的12个月，我们看到来新南威尔士州旅游的中国游客数量呢，达到了澳大利亚历史的顶峰。但是在刚才前面我所提到的这70万旅游人次当中，仅仅只有6%的中国游客有去参观和拜访在悉尼市以外的地方，也就是说94%的游客都还是仅仅只是在悉尼市之内进行观光，他们并没有离开悉尼市。我相信通过像特莱士酒庄度假村这样的项目，可以导引更多的中国国籍游客去参与到悉尼市以外的地方，去感受我认为在悉尼市以外新南威尔士州可以为国际游客带来的更多风光及旅游的特色。
So, in conclusion, on behalf of the New South Wales government, I want to congratulate Chairman Wei and everyone else who has been involved in this very exciting project. And I sincerely hope that this is the first of what will be many more very exciting and large-scale tourism investment projects in our state. Thank you.
最后，我仅代表新南威尔士州政府再次恭喜魏主席及所有特莱士酒店度假村项目的合作伙伴。我希望特莱士酒庄度假村项目可以成为在未来更多的吸引来自中国游客的旅游度假项目的第一个项目，并且在未来希望我们有更多的项目得以发展落地，并实现进一步向前发展，芝麻开花节节高。谢谢。
Thank you very much to the Minister for your high words and recognitions and synergy about this new vision of this project, and of course what Mr. Chairman Wei is delivering for the local economy. And of course, we're moving forward, we will be having our architect, Mr. Timus Wisher, our senior architect who has over 35 years of experience in architect design and urban design.Early days in 1999, he's already done super massive project in Shanghai with 4,000 villas, 3,000 apartments, and over 100,000 square meters of retail shops, hotels, and schools, and many more. So, may I invite your host to welcome Mr. Tim Swisher.
Right, well, thank you very much, Minister. Thank you, Wei Ping.What an amazing experience to be able to design a unique and special resort in the Hunter Valley. So, I'll be very simple, and perhaps Paul, you could say something to make it clear, or Adam, but I just want to...Say, here we are in Sydney. Here we are in Hunter Valley. 2 hours. Hunter Valley is 15 hours from Pudong International Airport. Okay? That's interesting. That is significant. That is about the 94% that the minister has just mentioned. We have to get those 94%from Pudong PBG to there. And that's what we are going to do.
Here we are,
right in the best location. We are at the gateway, you could say, to Hunter. We are on M15, M15. It is special because it has two entrances. One entrance,
Lovedale Road.
Another entrance, Wine Country Road. Two entrances. So if you miss one, you get the other one. If you miss one, you get the other one. So it is a destination. It is a great destination. It will be a destination. It will be unique because it is not like any other. It is not like all the others in Hunter Valley. It is special because it will be a destination that people will go to go to other places in the Hunter Valley, like ballooning or horse riding or something. We have a master plan. I'll talk about that really quick in a minute. We have a lot of special consultants, experts, special experts. One is here tonight, Mr. Wozniak, expert town planner. But I want to say, there are three reasons. There are three special things we will do here. Three special things. The first one is we will create, as Wei Ping has said, a special countryside hunter experience. The 94% want to understand Australia. Not Brazil or Mexico or Africa, but Australia. So the hunter experience is number one. Number one. Number two is they want to understand the mix of wine and food, wine culture, wine. Tell us why. Number two. They want their friends to understand the wine. And number three, they want to be in a beautiful Australian place. That means, it means wool sheds maybe, big roofs, big country style roofs, corrugated iron, wood, stone, all that stuff. That means Australia. It is special. So three things. Hunter, wine, and the architecture style, the style of the environment, the natural style. But modern, modern also. Because remember, you have many competitors here in the Hunter Valley, many excellent competitors, so it must be very good. What else must it do? There will be day guests. There will be day guests coming for 3 hours, 4 hours, 2 hours. And then there will be overnight guests. People coming for the weekend, a couple of days for dinner, for a conference, for a walking group, for a horse riding group, for a ballooning group, who knows? Two groups. Day group, overnight group. And the way we'll make this happen is we have to create many experiences. So when people come here, they have to have special experiences, special sequence of experiences. For example, for the day people, the day group, there needs to be special things to do. Maybe a maze. Maybe a bird area, maybe a farmyard zoo, and so on. Many things to do for day people. Very important. But we also have to make it very special. When you arrive and come to this wine cellar door, you have to feel something special, something dramatic is happening. You have to see grapevines, you have to feel something special is happening. I want this to be a very strong feeling of grapes, wine, vineyard, you know, this, like this. So you're arriving, you're coming into the gate from Tucker Lane, you're coming into the gate and you're coming towards the buildings and you will feel something about grapes. It is different, it is special. We might have a fishing pond for day visitors, for kids. We might have adventure play. We might have something special, not just a maze from England, but a maze from Australia, a maze from the Hunter Valley. a boomerang mat, something like that. Maybe something like this. Something like that, maybe. Maybe something like this for people who just want a special experience to stay in a tent. Why not? I went there one night. The night sky is black, black, and you can see the stars. So we would like to make a place where you can sit at night and look at the stars. You can't see the stars in Sydney, but you can see them here. Also, maybe it's a good place for weddings. Many things. And sculpture, maybe. Sculpture in the vineyard. Sculpture. So it's artistic as well as natural. It's cultured as well as natural. The buildings will have big roofs, a lot of wood, a lot of stone, a lot of corrugated iron. They will have beautiful interiors of wood, where people can taste wine, buy wine. We want it to be welcoming. We want it to have an Australian feeling. We want it to have a big veranda, where everyone will sit at 4 o'clock, have a drink, look at the sunset. This is the classic Australian experience, to go out onto the veranda, to sit under the grapevines, to have a drink, to have dinner. This is the key experience, the connection of inside to landscape. Inside to landscape. You can see the entry road. You can see the buildings. You can see all the things for day guests, And you can see things for weekend guests as well. But this is an idea for our building, an idea. It might have a beautiful tasting room. A table, 20 meters long, 30 meters long, 40 meters long, big table. A beautiful restaurant where you can have lunch. A place where you can buy honey and whatever, soap, incense. A big veranda, where you can have a drink, you can look at the vineyard, you can relax. Maybe a place for kids, children, games rooms, mahjong. Why not? Maybe even a mini IMAX for AV, audio visual, AV. Big projection, a screen, 5 meters high, big. Movies, who knows? Could be a hotel, perhaps, for wedding guests, maybe. It could be a spa. There are a lot of ponds and pools as well. Could be a spa. We will also have about 20 beautiful villas, 15, 20 beautiful villas, places to stay for the weekend, places to stay. Lake villas. Villas by the lake, by the water. Villas in the forest. The forest is important. It is full of kangaroos and lizards and gum trees. Forest villas. This is the sunset, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock.
Beautiful.
And some villas in the vineyard as well. But they all have one special quality. They all have big roofs, big roofs, big roof. A lot of wood, wood everywhere, and stone. They feel part of the landscape. They are part of the landscape, part of the natural world, I think. People will want to go there. It's different from Shanghai. Yeah. That's really all I have to say, I think. I just wanted to give you a snapshot. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Squashaw. I'm surely looking forward to seeing the world record, a 14 meters long table. I've never seen that in my life before. Looking forward to the completion of this fascinating project. Okay, moving forward, we have a number of guests, the next speakers that will be walking on stage. The wine owner will be introducing the local wine market and the local wine brands, and wine and food, how they're pairing up a characteristic of Hunter Valley wine. Only people come from the industries in Hunter Valley can represent a clearer concept of this such a topic they will speak. So I'd like to welcome, your applause to welcome the next gentleman, the sales and marketing director of Joko Family Wine, is Matthew Tadlow-Tomsay.
Thank you very much. I echo the previous talker's sentiments. This is a seriously exciting project you've all embarked on, in a country that's sought after around the world in their wines and in your home market in China. And the Jovel Wine Group, we're a family-owned business, but we are making wine in six countries at the moment, and Australia is a really a key part of what we're doing. So there's some guests of me tonight. Our chairman Frank Capps is here, and Matt Graham looks after all our accommodation hotels and resorts throughout Australia, so definitely someone to chat to when you're planning. But a very exciting project, so I congratulate you on your purchase, and Hunter Valley, one of Australia's oldest regions, and very exciting project. A little snapshot of the Jovel Wine Group. We're a vertically integrated wine group. We produce wine in six countries. Our main production is Australia. It's in New Zealand also, following closely behind as well. We own our own logistics company, so we distribute all our wines throughout the country, throughout. We own our distribution as well. All our reps on the road are owned by us as well. We also have our local investments. So we've invested in vineyards through Victoria, New Zealand. A couple more from New Zealand coming on board, and also internationally as well. So I'm here today to talk to you about what's happening in the Australian landscape, the Australian wine industry. Obviously, it's something that's important with your investment at the moment in Hunter Valley to know what's happening within our industry here. It's evolving very quickly, it's changing very quickly, but also I'll speak a little bit about our export market. The two are vastly different at the moment, which is exciting, but I guess it's an important piece to understand as winery investors in moving into the project you're moving into and delivering a product that not only Australian consumers are looking for, but also your international guests are looking for as well. So what's happening in the Australian industry right now? Evolution is happening within our market. We have a lot more winemakers, a lot more younger winemakers coming on board that are throwing out a lot of the older techniques. We're using a lot less oak use. We're choosing vineyards that are of cooler climate, higher elevation is particular. Hunter Valley is not higher elevation, it's a cooler climate, so it's something that will play a part in this discussion here. I'll talk to you about innovation, definitely in winemaking techniques, which is important for the product you're going to be producing. And what we're seeing in the Australian market, innovation through fruit production, winery production, winery management, and oak use as well is very important. And the rise of alternate varieties, and this is one that I think is important for wine Hunter Valley, but also for the Australian industry. As climate changes quickly in Australia, as we warm as a country, vineyards and winemakers and viticulturists are looking for varieties that are going to excel in this ever-changing climate. So Italian, Spanish and these sort of varieties are excelling, and we're seeing a sort of a stagnation or a slowing of traditional varieties, Cabernet, Chardonnay and Shiraz. So Tempranillo, Sangiovese, these sort of red varieties, Grunewaldina, some Austrian white varieties that do typically well in climates that have a lot of rainfall and quite warm in temperature are now coming through. And Hunter Valley, you're situated quite well to produce these varieties. As I said, climate change is really driving the change, the sustainable viticulture as well, as we're not trying to use as much water as we can here in Australia. It's pretty strict. We're not trying to water our vines as much. And authenticity for consumers, this will be an important part. And we're seeing a massively increase in our export market. We're seeing a decline in OEMs or BOBs as far as producing wines that are produced in a marketing lab. People want wines with authenticity. They want vineyard designation, and you in this room have purchased a beautiful vineyard in one of the oldest wine regions in the world, so it's something you should be playing with and pushing quite heavily as far as your marketing pitch. Regions driving the change. I'll do a quick run through some of the regions in Australia. Obviously you have Barossa and McLaren Vale, some of the bigger wines that have here over Australia for a while. There's quite a number of regions that are heroing Italian varieties. And McLaren Vale, which has always been a Shiraz dominant, Cabernet dominant region, is now producing some of Australia's greatest Sangiovese, Nero d'Avola, Fiano in whites for Italian wine. So really getting off that Shiraz track, and I'll show you some stats soon to show why. Obviously the Hunter Valley has as well. It's a cooler region. It hasn't got the elevation of some regions, but it is cool. It's Australia's oldest region, so you can use that as part of your extreme marketing prowess. Semillon is coming back into vogue, which has always been a strong part of Hunter Valley. Tempranillo as well is an interesting variety, and it has got the capability to grow other varieties outside Shiraz. This is an important graph to look at, I think, for the domestic market here in Australia, and it really shows the last 4 or 5 years from a domestic sales perspective what's growing and what's declining. Especially when setting up a winery and setting up a wine business as you are right now, it's important to know what's working for your consumers domestically. But domestically, so domestic sales are still going to be a big part of what you can do. We can see Prosecco, Italian Prosecco, or Prosecco in generally, domestically produced Prosecco, and Rosé as categories are by far the biggest growth trends in our industry here, and also around the world as well. They're exceeding expectations. You can see things like Cabernet and Shiraz and Sauvignon Blanc are flattening off and declining, and I think as an infancy in your business where you're looking at what do you plan? If you're planning new vineyards, you're doing a lot of development around your vineyards as far as infrastructure. What are the varieties that are going to work best? And what are the varieties that are going to sell best? Is what you want as well. Us as a wine business, we continue looking for varieties that are selling best. It's great to produce varieties that we think are fantastic, but if you're not selling them, then they're not providing the best revenue. Other way. Here's a simple graph, again, from some domestic sales across these varieties. And you can see Cabernet Sauvignon, Sauvignon Blanc, and Shiraz. Shiraz is in a very deep decline in Australia as far as sales is concerned. Very different to the export market, which we'll show in a minute. But as far as domestic sales, the Australian consumer is heading away from Shiraz. And I think it's due to the bigger, oakier, alcoholic styles that we've produced in the past. we're seeing some winemaking techniques which you should be taking into some of your philosophies as well, is picking earlier, lower alcohols. Wine, and especially the Chinese market, we go in and see it as a health product, lower alcohol, less oak use, and less intervention on winemaking. I think it's extremely important. Less acid additions, less sugar additions, less tannin additions, less gum additions, less oak chip additions. People are wanting wines of sense of place. You've got a beautiful vineyard, get the viticulture right, pick when the wines are ready, no additions, and you can say to your consumers, these are sense of place wines, these are wines that are picked, zero additions. And I think we're seeing things like Rosé and Prosecco, which are very fresh and lively, wines that are produced very and drunk very young, coming into vogue. Pinot Gris and Pinot Grigio, which would grow very well in the Hunter Valley, are coming into vogue. Chardonnay is on a very steep comeback, which has always produced very well in the Hunter Valley. People like Tyrrells have always had some of Australia's best Chardonnay produced there. So an interesting stat on what's happening in some of our major wine varieties. And just to finish, a very brief little export. So I guess some of the varieties that aren't working so well here in decline, and some numbers around what is working in China. Obviously, China has a thirst for Australian wine, so Shiraz, Cab, and those sort of blends are still very important. So still very important to produce. But just some interesting statistics around there. So again, I congratulate you on your investment. It's extremely exciting. I'm looking forward to seeing what comes over the next few years as far as your wine and your infrastructure comes. So congratulations. Thank you for inviting us, and enjoy the night, and well done. And look forward to seeing what comes in the future. Thank you.
As earlier I've mentioned, this hotel right here is one of the most prestigious hotels in Sydney, and many of the notables worldwide visit this hotel, stayed, and party price is food and beverages. So, I do remember Prince Diana and Clinton to visit here. So, in which is what I next would like to invite the actual head chef of Intercontinental here in Double Bay, Mr. Alex Vigils, and go through what you will be having on your table as main course, and how will you be pairing with your wine and etc. Applause to welcome.
Evening, everyone. Welcome to the Intercontinental Double Bay. As described, I'm Alex Richards, as every chef here. And I'm just going to go through the entrees, mains, and desserts, give a little bit of description on each of the courses that we're having tonight. So firstly, we actually had a tasting plate. So we had a Spencer Gulf kingfish, and also we had our Yamba prawns. So the Yamba prawns were ceviche style, and the kingfish were a sashimi style that was with some avocado and also some shiso. The ceviche had a hint of coconut and also some citrus. Then we moved on to our South Australian Coffin Bay scallop, Coffin Bay oysters with the yuzu gel and some black caviar. So this just gives you a little bit of taste of the seafood from around Australia. Going on from that, we have our Riverina beef. So that's with the local and also in-season roasted beetroots. There's some pepper paste and also some bacon with that. That'll go quite well with the shiraz you're drinking this evening. And also to our Tasmanian sea king salmon. So that's with some sage potatoes, roasted garlic, lemongrass cavlong, just to give that Asian touch to that dish, and that will combine very well with the Delo. And then lastly, we have our dessert. So our dessert is a classic dessert. It's our water seed pavlova, Australian native ingredient. And that's with fresh berries, passion fruit, and another custard. So you can enjoy the wine, enjoy the food, and also within our company. So thank you very much.
Today is celebrating this great venture heading forward. It's a very precious occasion where we gather people's wisdom and same values, and of course people who will share future prosperities all together. And of course, thank you very much for our guest of honor attending tonight, the Honorable Adam Marshall. And the Tellace Vinery Resort Project introductory gala dinner has come to a segment where we can finally reunion and make some new friends in the next 2 years. And certainly welcome you to stay to enjoy some more of the friendship, divine food, wine for the rest of the night. And we're anticipating the next brilliant project announcement coming soon. Okay, see you very soon. Bye.
That we're in.